Hello and welcome to the OWC instructional series of videos. In this installment, we're going to show you how to install a 1.8-inch ZIF drive in the USB 2 enclosure that comes as part of the OWC ZIF Solid State Drive Kit for the early 2008 MacBook Air. We've gathered our materials and are working on a soft, static-free surface. We are now ready to begin. We've already upgraded the drive in our early 2008 MacBook Air with the OWC SSD, so now we have the enclosure that came with the SSD and the original drive, which we'll set aside for a moment. The first step is to flip the enclosure over and gently pull the bottom cover off. Inside, you'll find a bag of 8 small screws and a sheet of rubber bumpers, which can also be set aside. Then, peel the top cover away, leaving just the center frame assembly. In order to attach the ribbon cable, the black lever on the drive's ZIF connector needs to be in the open position. If it isn't, gently lift it open using your nylon pry tool. Make sure you have the assembly and drive arranged so that the ZIF connectors are facing up. Then, slide the ribbon cable into the slot on the hard drive. Once the two pieces are together, use your nylon pry tool to gently push the black lever back into the closed position. At this point, it's a good idea to test the drive to make sure you've seated the ribbon cable correctly. Use the USB cable that came with the kit to attach the assembly to a running computer. If the blue light comes on, everything is hooked up correctly. Eject the disk if it's mounted on your desktop, then disconnect it from your computer. We can now close everything up. If you're putting in a brand new 1.8-inch drive, then you may wish to put some of the rubber pieces on the top and bottom of the drive to help keep it in place. Since we're using the drive from an early 2008 MacBook Air, the foam on the outside will serve the same purpose. Disconnect the USB cable and gently fold the ribbon so that the drive lays flat within the frame. Take the case with the OWC logo and place it over the top, making sure that the cutout for the USB connection lines up properly. You can then turn the assembly over and set the bottom cover into place. Finally, use your Phillips screwdriver to attach the 8 tiny screws that hold the enclosure together. Your external ZIF drive is now ready to use.